Hopefully by now God has your full attention. I say God and not coronavirus because who do you think is behind this? You think it was an accident that last week when we read the Megillah on Purim, the Purim story, and we read about Vinahapach, how things flipped upside down in an eye blink. Haman, who had built a gallows specifically to hang Mordechai, was hanged on that gallows? That same week, there are newspaper headlines across the world blaring, "World turned upside down." That's no coincidence. Every so often, God peeks out from behind the curtain and says, "Hey, here I am. Remember me?" And right now, he's peeking out like never before in our lives. And whether we're sick, God forbid, or quarantined, or shut in, or just plain worried as our lives have been turned upside down, we'll want to know what's going to be. What's going to happen? So even though I'm not a prophet, I'm not even a rabbi, I just pretend to be one once a week on these videos, I want to make two bold predictions. Number one, life will return to normal. It looks like it won't be weeks. Hopefully it will be months and not years, but things will settle down and return to normal. Warren Buffett, world's greatest investor, the Oracle of Omaha, has been buying shares of Delta Airlines. You'll say, has he lost his mind? The airlines are going to go bankrupt. They're not flying. He's betting on things returning to normal. That whether it's in weeks or months or longer, eventually those airline stocks will rebound and he'll make a killing, as he so often has. Far more often in his career, he's been right than wrong. He's betting on things going back to normal. I'm predicting he's right. I really hope he's right. My second bold prediction, life will return to normal. Looks like it won't be weeks. Hopefully it'll be months and not years. And you're saying, is this Groundhog Day? Wasn't that his first prediction? And the answer is no. Because now I'm talking about our religious, our spiritual lives. Once life goes back to normal, we'll go back to normal, back to our comfort zone, hitting that snooze button, which we invented, not God. Just let me go back to sleep. It's so comfortable where I am. We'll go back to our old levels of observance, which for most of us consist of occasional episodes of intense devotion to God, interspersed with far longer periods of absent-mindedness, forgetfulness, carelessness, even recklessness or rebelliousness. Now imagine the difference. You got a baby right now who has no idea what's going on, doesn't know what a quarantine is just looking for his or her next bottle or diaper change, but in 10 years is reading an article and says, "Mom, Dad, or Grandma, Grandpa, what's coronavirus?" And you say, "Oh, let me tell you about 2020. That's when the world turned upside down." And you explain what happened. And then that child says, "And then what happened?" And you say, "Oh, well then, life went back to normal. It was difficult, there were many losses, but life for the most part went back to normal." Versus, with a big smile, with tremendous pride, you say, "That's when we decided to start keeping Shabbos. That's when we decided to start keeping kosher. That's when we decided to start praying. That's when we decided to start giving charity. That's when we decided to start studying the Torah." Or if you were already doing those things, that's when we decided to stop speaking Lashon Hara, to stop saying negative things about other people. That's when we decided never again to speak during prayer services. That's when we decided to give more charity, to do more Torah study. That's when we decided to start a chesed organization, and we're still doing it now. Can you imagine the difference? And so you'll say, "Okay, how do I pick? What do I work on? There are like 613 different things." Well, now you're asking the right guy. Give me a second. Let me go get my sorting hat.
Difficult, very difficult. Better be Gryffindor!
I'm kidding, of course. I don't have a sorting hat. I'm not Harry Potter. I'm a different Harry. I can't tell each one of you specifically what to concentrate on. I can only make a humble suggestion that you make a list. Put a line down the middle. On one side, list 3, 4, 5 things between you and God that you'd like to work on. Shabbos, kosher, prayer, holidays, study. And then on the other side, list 4 things between man and man that you'd like to work on. Lashon Hara, charity, honoring your father and mother. And then on each side of that list, pick the easiest one on each side. The easiest one between you and God, the easiest one between you and man, and commit to those. You'll say, "Why the easiest? Why not dream big?" And the answer is because you want to pick two things that you'll keep doing when life returns to normal, when that little voice is whispering in your ear, hit the snooze button. Go back to your comfort zone. If in a year you're still doing those two things, go back to that list that you've hopefully kept typed into your phone. And then you can go up one and again, add on the easiest thing on each side of the list. But do something. When life goes back to normal, don't go back to your normal level of observance. Hatzlacha, and stay safe.